Why do you think that your name is not brought up in conversations as like, you know, some of the top, you know, based on what you did in the league? Because you were dropping 50, 60 like Curry and them has been doing, but nobody really thinks about that. Do you think it's because they didn't watch, or you were in a market where people didn't see you, or you feel like your career was cut short because of injury?
The cut short part, but I think success winning comes with, you know, so.
So you got, you were putting up the numbers, but the you weren't winning.
I wasn't winning, so it was still this, he has a lot of numbers, but there's no, so what ends up happening is, I said, I opened the market for the Currys, the Dames, the Westbrook style of that point guard being a dominant scorer, but Curry established it because he won. He won being a scoring guard first. And the fact that he won, it became, all right, this is not just a hybrid player. This is a point guard. And we're going to put this point guard numbers up against passing numbers. Mm-hmm. So now, you know, now someone like Steph, his numbers trumps in the scoring categories and all these categories over all these point guards who wasn't scoring and they were just trying to get the team involved. So like I seen something today that said Curry is king of the turnaround. And I agree, even though I'm the guy who started it. The turnaround shot, walk away, the king goes walk.
Okay.
Like,
shoot and just walk away.
Yeah. His was, you shot a turnaround before you knew it
and
was
I,
going
But in. I did it a couple of times. Like, yeah, I started it. He mastered it. So he is the king
of
it.
He just takes
like,
off, runs down the floor.
Yeah, he's the king of it. Like, yeah, I gave the idea, but he took it to a whole nother level. So I can't put claim to something.
You did it first.
I did it first, but he did it better. He did it a lot better.
And at a different time, too.
Like, I did it on game winners. He hasn't done it on game winners. He did it. He's done it throughout the game.
Curry, that's a challenge right there.
It ain't even a challenge.
Yeah, it is, because you got to do it on a game winner. It's one thing to do it in the course of the game, in Florida game, but to do it on a game winner, that's on another level.
But he's done it 100 times.
I get that, but on a game winner, that's on another level.
Well, I'll argue for him. The fact that that they were beating people, he was sitting down in third quarters, he never really had chances to do it for the game.
True. Now,
I'll argue for him on that one. True, you know, he was beating everybody's ass, so he didn't really have to.
Right,
I think that's the reason that I get lost in the shuffle, is because when I was doing it, there was no real reference, because Baron Davis was a point guard who can score, but he was still a point guard.
Yeah, he could.
Then they gave Marbury. They just stamped him with Ball Hog, you know, the Ball Hog stamp. You know, then you had Steve Francis, who was the next hybrid.
Yeah, he could.
But he wasn't just the assassin scorer. He was more of the highlight reel. So he was that flashy guard that came in and put people in the seats.
Right,
yeah. I came in straight assassin mode. Like, it was just, I'm here to try to score 30 every game.
Right.
I don't know about all that other stuff. I'm going to go.
You straight shoot.
So what ends up happening is, and then once I fall off, then you got the Currys, the Dames. But that's why Dame doesn't get the same credit, because Dame hasn't won that championship. And that's why Curry gets the head, because he's a champ. He's an MVP. So because of the status came with it, that's where, but he opens it up for the Trae Youngs and everyone else too. Right. So.